The yellow Argiope spider, known to me as the garden spider, is one of my favorites to see hanging around. They're native to North America and are often found near sunny open areas like the side of your house or in the greenhouse or garden. Females are easy to spot with their large size, yellow-black bodies, and silver faces. It's where they get their name, Argiope arantia, silver gilded face. The males are smaller and lack the brilliant colors. This kind of sexual dimorphism is common amongst orbweavers, so from here on we won't pay the guys much attention. This orbweaver builds her web daily, often showcasing the central zipper pattern where she perches, waiting for her next meal. Deadly to insects and small vertebrates, they make an excellent companion spider. Docile, harmless to us, and unlike some other orbweavers, considerate with their web placement, sticking to corners and gaps instead of being centered in walkways. I've walked through more than my fair share of spider webs, but not one of these guys. The Golden Silk Orbweaver is another native variety with a little bit more southern distribution. They bear a resemblance to the garden spider, but are orange to brown in color with a yellow spot pattern. They prefer to call the forest their homes, building their webs spanning between shrubs or trees. Their name comes from the golden tint of their silk. It's pretty strong stuff. There's another spider, similar at first glance with a very different story. Introduced from Asia and now thriving as a well-established invasive species, the Joro spider. I saw one of these for the first time about 10 years ago. Now I see them or walk through several of their webs a day. At first glance, their coloration and size resemble our native garden spider, but if you're comfortable getting close to them, you can see that their color pattern and abdominal shape are different. This is a mature female Joro spider, yellow and black, with a gray-green band pattern, and that little guy near her is a hopeful suitor. He'll stay nearby, waiting for the possibility that she becomes receptive to mating, trying to bounce a distance between being noticed and being able to escape from becoming dinner. Unlike Argiope and the Golden Silk Orbweaver, the Joro spider seems to be happy building their web anywhere they can. An easy way to tell who you're looking at from a distance is the web. Our native orbweavers stick to a single, well-designed web. The garden spider with her nostalgic zigzag, and the golden orbweaver with her strong golden silk. Joro, the invasive lookalike, builds a three-layered web. A central web between two nets of messy strands. It's part of what makes walking through them so distinguished. You get three webs to the face, all in the same step. But back to this lovely lady. These brown sacs hold thousands of eggs. Their mother won't survive the winter, but come spring, her babies will hatch and emerge into the world, staying nearby or traveling great distances. The small hatchlings can spin strands of silk, like seed fluff or parachutes, and fly away on the wind to find a new home, carrying on the next generation and beginning the cycle anew. We don't yet know the full impact of the Joro spider on our native species. Maybe they'll help control other invasives. Maybe they'll compete for food. Establishment can happen in a matter of months, but it can take decades to see all the ripples. What I do know is that change comes fast, and a familiar face can vanish in an instant. The garden spider of my childhood and the Joro spider of today. Ever-changing, and it's part of our cycle. The world, the forest, the land I see will not be the same for my daughter when she's walking her path.